Welcome to my channel. I am Grzyszulid. You can catch me on Twitch almost every day and now have fun with the video. Welcome YouTube to the patch notes rundown of AFK Arena's newest patch 1.65. So first off, we finally get the long-awaited Celestial Tower, unfortunately not Hypergen, and we get another new hero yet again, which will be the new Lightbearer hero that we can see on the right side of the screen already. We'll get onto him in a few seconds as well, but let's start off. The first page of the patch notes is basically just the time and when it will hit test servers and 1.2k diamonds as compensation, as per usual, so that's nice obviously, but nothing new. Then the new hero, Walker the Lone Ranger, that you can see on the right side of your screen already. Yeah, he'll get his own Bountiful Trials as per usual, and will be available to be tested as well, as each new hero is. So let's first give my opinion to that hero. Art wise, since we can't talk too much about skills, it most likely seems like a ranger, which seems nice. Maybe a new Lightbearer carry, hopefully, that's what they need. But I don't like the fact that we get another new hero in such short notice, basically. We were pumped with so many new heroes that it's pretty much impossible to keep up nowadays, and really hard for free-to-play players ever to catch up on to established accounts, and yeah, that seems really fucking weird, the amount of stuff they're pumping out. I'm happy if that's going to be like a decent Lightbearer carry though, since Lightbearer carry is really fucking needed by now. So if that's the carry, then I'm happy. If it's not a carry and it's an underwhelming unit, I'm really bumped out that we get another hero and it's not even a problem solving one. Like, if it's a new hero that fixes an issue that's currently happening, then sure. If it's just an addition for Lightbearers that doesn't really change anything, then I'm just bummed that we got another hero on short notice. Yeah, that's my fault. I don't like the artwork too much, but it's not the worst. I mean, yeah, whatever. We'll see his skill set. I really hope it's Ranger, Celerity, whatever you want to call it. Okay, let's go over to the next page. So the second part of the patch notes. They added new stages for the faction towers for King's Tower, which is a nice addition. Doesn't affect a whole lot of players, but still, it's something. Heroes for hire. Oh, okay. Yeah, the unions will be checked on the 1st and 15th of each month. And in between, if you had them at the start of that one, then yeah, you'll keep them. And once you unlock them, you will keep them, and then it will check 1st and 15th. I mean, it released some pressure off of Lilith to not constantly check anymore. I don't know how it did beforehand, but yeah. Yeah, it's fine. Doesn't hurt players, and yeah, Lilith servers won't be as... need to do less calculations, I guess. Optimize the visual performance of Dory's Corner entrance and pop a window within the Noble Tavern. Yeah, I mean, who fucking cares? I mean, surely some care, but yeah. I mean, optimizing visuals is just a quality of life thing, nothing too major, and yeah, not game changing whatsoever. Optimizing the visual performance of Fortune Chest, related interfaces pages, yeah, whatever that means. Oh wait, Fortune Chests are the ones you gain out of Twisted Realm, I think. So that's not too bad. I think they were pretty poorly visible and you couldn't like research what you got, I think, once you unlock them, but I'm not too sure. I mean, yeah, just quality of life again. Nothing really important. Hi, Kirby. Welcome, welcome. I'm doing a short rundown for YouTube right now of the patch notes. We can talk in a second. Added additions, optimizations. Yeah, a new Voyage of Wonders. Okay, beautiful. Then we get another wandering balloon feature. We haven't gotten one in a while, I don't think. So yeah, two nice additions with rewards, but nothing like that's really interesting. Like, just something we get each patch, nothing particularly important. Then the new Celestial Tower called the Celestial Sanctum. That is something that has been long awaited. I am really happy about the addition finally. It has been leaked like a couple of months ago already, and a lot of players thought it wasn't coming. We get Celestial Tower. I think it was Celestial Hypergen at the time that it was announced. So we'll get them divided into two, which is really fucking nice. I am looking forward to getting the Hypergen one as well. And yeah, that is like a really great one that I have been looking forward. And I'm happy about that. And then reduce the difficulty of High King's Tower stages. Won't be affecting most of the players, and increase the overall an amount of King's Tower stages. So really high accounts will be happy about that, but it won't affect 95% of the player base, maybe even more. Yeah, it's the faction towers, the fifth one, right? Didn't I already mention faction towers? Is that the same one? Wait, I'm confused. I don't know. Added a new animation effect to new hero displays to the hero trial page. Yeah, no one really cares. Optimization the visuals of the 7-day newcomer login event only affects new players. If it looks better than before, then I guess it's a nice quality of life change again. And then the last two things, which usually can change a bit, but this time around it's Lawson. For PvE, that won't change a thing. I think Windworn was his shield ability, if I'm not incorrect. And yeah, just fixed targeting. I'm not sure how if it has any effects on PvP, but I doubt it will. I think it will pretty much be the same hero after and before, and for PvE it doesn't change a single thing since he's mainly used for Link, and that's it. Thorin and the Fallen King optimize the visuals of Thorin's animation and increase his character muscle's resolution. So a higher resolution Thorin. Thorin, our favorite hero. We can't complain about that one whatsoever. And yeah, so that covers the overall patch. Yeah, when going over the patch, the two most interesting things is obviously the Celestial Tower that's finally been added, which I'm pretty happy about. And for the Lightbearer, he'll get his own video once we know his abilities and if he's and what class he will be. Overall, I'm unhappy and happy at the same time that we get a new hero. I'm unhappy about that one already, since I don't like them spamming heroes each new patch. But I'm happy about it if the Lightbearer here will finally fix the issue of not having a carry for Lightbearers, as I mentioned earlier. So yeah, YouTube, that's it. If you want to catch me live, you can do so on Twitch, and I'm great to lead. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye!